Well, it's sunset again. It's later now. Days are getting longer. It's 7:51. And the days are getting longer. They've been getting longer since December, and we've just about reached the longest time. Today is the yesterday was Wednesday the 26th. And I was really disappointed because it was cloudy in the morning. Now, I pretty much knew I wasn't going to be able to see the eclipse of the moon because it was cloudy in the evening, too, Tuesday evening. And then I got up yesterday morning at 3 o'clock in the morning and just woke up quite naturally. Well, I woke up because I had to go pee. That's actually good news because now I've been getting up every 3 or 4 hours, sometimes even 5 hours before I have to get up, because I don't drink as much coffee in the evening. I used to get up every 2 hours almost. I thought it was good when I didn't get up for 3 hours. Well, now I'm going 4, sometimes 5 hours. Like right now. It's been about 4 hours since I went to the toilet. And that's because I'm not drinking as much tea and coffee, especially the coffee. I'm still drinking alcohol. It's not my second, because I had some wine with lunch, but this is my second cocktail in the evening. Oh. God, I love drinking. But as long as I don't drink a lot, I feel better. I haven't had beer in months, because the last time I had beer, I had to pee really bad. For some reason, tequila doesn't make me pee all the time like coffee and beer did. Even wine doesn't make me pee, but the problem is not that it makes me pee, it makes me fat. Anyhow, I was really upset yesterday because I couldn't see the eclipse of the moon. The moon was right there, except there were all these clouds. I sat out here for half an hour looking at the clouds reflecting the lights of the city. Then I went in and watched it a little bit on the internet and felt sorry for myself. Isn't that damn silly? Here I am, 70 years old, I've had a pretty good life, and I'm feeling sorry for myself because I couldn't see the moon. That's stupid. Well, it's evening again. And I'm hoping I can see Venus again this evening. It's been 5 or 6 days since we had an evening that was clear enough to really. And I don't know if I'll be able to see Sirius tonight. It's a few days ago, the last time I saw it, 5 or 6 days ago, it was sinking so far down in the west that I hardly got a glimpse of it before it went behind the houses, behind the horizon. But this is about the time, according to my computer ephemeris, which is the program that's called Stellarium, Venus is coming up over there in the west. It's slowly coming out of its orbit. It's really bright because it's coming out from behind the sun and it's fully lit up by the sun, shining and coming up, day by day getting a little bit higher. And it looks even though there's that streak of cloud I showed you across the horizon when I first turned the camera on, even though that cloud is over there, I see there's enough open sky that I might be able to catch a glimpse of Venus. Catch a glimpse. That reminds me of something that a cop in Washington, D.C. said to me years and years ago. I think I was 24 years old, and I was sitting out in front of the White House, and some of the federal police that guard the White House were coming by, and they said, hello. I said, hello, how are you? I said, hey, is there any chance I could see the president? And they stopped and they looked at me and they said, why would he want to talk to you? I said, I don't want to talk to him, I just want to see him. Why would he want to see you? You misunderstand me, I don't want to talk to him or anything, I just want to, see him walking by. You know, he said, oh, you don't mean you want to see him, you want to catch a glimpse. And that was when I learned the difference for those. Let's see, I think they were part of the Executive Protection Service. They guard the White House. Now, the Secret Service guards the president and the people. They guard the people. They guard the human bodies. But the building at that time, 50 years ago, 45 years ago, was 1975. 46 years ago. The building, the White House, was guarded by the Executive Protection Service. They also guarded the embassies and such. And I didn't realize for a while how much trouble I almost got myself in by saying I wanted to see the president. Oh man, they were asking me all kinds of, why would you want to see him? What do you want to say to him? I don't want to tell him anything. Why would he want to hear anything from me? I'm nobody. Oh, you just want to catch a glimpse of him. So that came to mind just now as I was thinking about, I'd like to see Venus or catch a glimpse of Venus. Yeah. Oh, there's my doggy over there trying to get in there. The doggy wants to come in the house. Hello, big dog. What you doing? Me and that dog get along a lot better than the White House guards and I did when I asked him if I could see the president. This dog just wants to see dinner. And me, I just want to catch a glimpse of Venus. It's getting a little darker now. The sun has set. Twilight has begun. We're now moving through the first part of twilight when everything's still real bright. You can still see me on the camera. And anyhow, my brother and I have been figuring out that we want to sell the house that we grew up in, that Mom kept for all the years after she moved out and started living with our stepfather. She kept the house and rented it. And we've been collecting the rent ever since Mom died. My brother and I have been collecting the rent, which is good. It means that I don't have to work very much. I don't have a lot of retirement. I have Medicare and I have a little bit of Social Security, but not enough to pay for hardly anything. And when I left the city to move to Tijuana, I took all my pension money and lived on it in Mexico for a while. So I don't have my pension from work. I just have the income from the renting the house. And I have a little bit of savings. You hear the dog? Hey dog, what's up with you? What you barking at? You want to say hello? Here you go. Come here. Come here. Yes. There you are. Look at you. This dog is what is called a labradoodle. It's half Labrador, half poodle. And it's a big hairy beast. And she's pretty vicious when she wants to be. And I'm lucky she likes me. I had to watch the animals for a couple of days. A few days ago when my brother and my nephew and my niece and my sister-in-law all went off on a little vacation. I got to take care of the animals. Not the whole time they were gone. First it was just some of them were gone, and then it was the others were gone, and then some came back. And so it was basically just 2 days when I had them all on my own. But it was a bit of a stress, because I like to do nothing. I like to just sit back and read books and write and have a drink in the evening. Although I admit, I like having wine with lunch sometimes. Anyhow, well, you can bark, but I'm not going to get up. Yes, big girl. Hear me patting her on the back. She likes that. Oh, yes, you do. You like that, don't you? Oh, yes, you do. Oh, you're going to scratch yourself. Oh, yes. Put your leg up. Pretend you're scratching yourself. What you doing? What you doing? It's almost, you can almost see. Oh, you're turning away. Come back here. The camera wants, hey, come here. Come here. The camera wants to see you. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. The camera wants to see you, you big old monster. Yes. Oh. You're gonna put your paw up on me now. Oh, look at you. I just put the camera down and now you put your paw up. Yeah. I like being alone. I always have. My brother and my nephew have gone off for a couple hours, so I'm able to sit out here and talk to the dogs and turn my camera on and watch the night come. Can't see Venus yet. Oh, there it is. I see it. I can see Venus. My goodness. It's so bright. It's so freaking bright. It's showing up even now in the twilight. Wow. And it's definitely higher than it was last time I saw it a couple days ago. It's climbing up, Bella. Venus is climbing up in the sky. Mm-mm. I don't think it's bright enough to show on the camera yet. I can't quite. I've tried to show it, and sometimes I have, but it's only when it gets darker that I can really be sure I'm seeing it on the camera. But it's definitely there. Yeah. Anyhow, my brother and I are going through signing the papers, and they did our address wrong, so now we can't sign the papers. We have to wait until they redo the listing contract. And we're hoping to have this thing on the market and within the next few days. And if we're lucky, sell it within a few weeks, because they say this is a seller's market. Everybody's paying ridiculously high prices for houses. It's in a nice neighborhood, very expensive neighborhood, but it's not a big house. It's a medium-sized house, and it's old. It needs work too. It was built in 1958, and it's, of course, we've done work on it through the years. Just a couple years ago, we did all kinds of plumbing work. New water heater, new toilets. Anyhow, it's It's going to be on the market probably next week, and we'll sell it hopefully within a couple of weeks, and then the escrow, as they say, will close in July. Will you please stop barking? I'm not going to let you in. Hush. No. And so then I'm still thinking about going back to New York and living there for a while when my daughter-in-law and my son have their baby, which will be in October, God willing. And I'm thinking about living in New York, in New York City. Of course, I couldn't afford it with the little bit of income I have now, but if we sell the house, I'll have a couple hundred thousand dollars and I'll be able to pay rent for a few months at least in New York. It's going to be expensive. The best place I'm looking at, I've been reading all the ads and all the listings and everything, and I'm probably going to have to spend about $2,000 a month just for a tiny one-bedroom apartment in Brooklyn, which is where my son and daughter-in-law live. So, damn, Venus looks brighter than ever. So I'll, hopefully in September or October, I'll be going back to New York. And if everything goes good, I'll actually drive there. I'll drive my van, my cargo van there, and then I'll have to worry about where to park the damn thing in New York. I may have to spend $800 a month just to put it in a garage. I think I'm going to try to show you Venus. It's right out there. It's right there somewhere. You may see it already, but I'm not picking it up. Let's see. It's above the right side of the midpoint of the house. And it's just as high above the clouds as the clouds are above the house. So it should be right there. How come I can't see it? You probably see it, but there it is. Yeah. There it is. Uh-huh. That's Venus. And it's hanging... Oh, hush, big girl. It's hanging in the western sky above the twilight horizon. And that's what I wanted to come out here to see. I'm not going to wait and see if I can see the stars, because I got a dog bitching at me. And I'll tell you a secret. She is a bitch.